All right. Let's load and continue on. 7.5 hours into the game. And about to raid a fortress, maybe? I think. The hell are you? Is that a plant? Or an abomination? It's a mall. The hell's a mall? Well, it's dead now.
Unarmed? Hardly. These are deadly weapons.
Doodly weapons. Sure are a lot of souls around here.
There's no guard. Do we just go in?
Wait. This isn't what I expected.
There's a barrier over it?
They changed the security.
You weren't kidding, were you? That scorpion and this barrier, all part of your curse.
Don't blame it on the curse.
A direct assault would be a bad idea. What's the plan?
Down the cliff.
As if he wasn't here, there wouldn't be a barrier, Velvet.
Check that.
You did your research.
I had to, didn't I?
Yoink.
Until we figure out how this barrier works, there's no way we're getting in through the front. Let's try finding a service entrance.
Ah, what's alive? So I've fought wolves, I've fought... Okay, let's not go fight those guys. Whatever. I fought wolves, I fought malls, I fought demon plants. How come I'm not fighting any bears in this Tales of Berseria? Really, that didn't destroy it? Okay, fine.
I'll cut down anyone in my way!
She'll cut down anyone in her way, unlike every other tales of protagonists who... Well, they also kind of cut down every single random enemy on the field in their way. I mean, that's kind of the same as every JRPG protagonist. I mean, what's one JRPG where you don't have to savage random creatures on the overworld field? Where's my pacifist option? Or is that only Mass Effect? And Fallout if you have enough skills. And Metal Gear, I suppose. Man, I hope I don't have to climb back up here.
This one's actually guarded.
Unlike the other one we saw with, like, five guards.
Let's move, everyone. Stop! Those guards are...
Careful! They're not what they seem!
They're crazy! They're lizard foes.
Transformed into demons!
What kind of curse is this, Aizen?
I warned you, didn't I?
Why do you keep thinking it's the curse? You're stupid?
You wouldn't expect these guards to carry the demon blight. Is this your curse again?
Probably.
Sure it is.
If I'd charged in, that might have turned ugly. Thank you for stopping me.
Stopping me so that we all charged in.
He's the one who noticed the danger.
In that case, I'll be counting on you to keep watch.
Mini Wesker,
after all,
you got my back.
We've got a Reaper with us. Who knows what else we'll find?
Sure, make him feel bad about it.
She's saying it's all right to talk.
Understood. Keeping watch.
I'll keep both eyes on. Oh, wait. I'll take this. And this. Life bottle. And this. Maybe those guards got the demon blight from these really creepy plant things here. I mean, no way these things are normal. Though they currently seem to be kind of out of it. Well, it was just waiting there. Whatever.
Ours.
Maybe because they're plants, they can't move? Never mind. They got fucking teleports. And they can move. Also, sup, Ab, sup, Norm, Nom.
Looks like there are demons inside as well. Don't tell me, Aizen, you're the source of demon blight.
Nope. It's just our bad luck to be around when it's.
How is it bad luck? It means
this
we don't have to fight these
to
dudes.
Walk with the Reaper. You've only yourselves to blame.
It works in our favor. The enemy won't be capable of an organized response.
And we're a small group. Our mobility will be an advantage in the chaos.
Always look on the bright side of life, bro.
So, Aizen, how do we open the sea gate?
The controls ought to be located in the upper part of the gate. We'll activate them and then send a signal.
Got it. To the top of the gate, then.
Vortigern, sea gate fortress. The hell are you? Neat. And then we got a bat just because. And a wall. The wall! The wall! Nothing on earth can make it fall! When you come to and you can't go through and you can't knock it down, you know that you found the wall! The wall! The wall! I'm personally just happy to be here. Ow. I should really learn how to use my arts.
Well then, let's move on.
wrong way. Wall man. They should have named him Wallaby.
Hey, not all the ships left.
A battleship. Not good.
Let's sink it.
A fortress with a sea gate that blocks the entire strait. It's crazy what the Abbey can build.
Until recently, I might not have believed it possible.
It's no sweat. If you're using Malachim as tools.
Slaves.
Malachim can be
just
made of
wood
to fell demons. They can also be made a hammer to forge metal.
It's another way the Abbey and the Kingdom show their dominance to the people. It says, do not resist. Submit.
It's disgusting is what it is.
Disgusting.
Agreed.
It's a battleship, all right. Look at all the cannons it doesn't have. No cannons, no guns. No crewmen. Someone dropped a copper coin over here. What were they doing on the ramparts? Mustache. Come on, the dude didn't even have a voice.
This door should lead to the gate, but it looks like they've got it locked up tight.
Well, brute force is out.
Intruders! How dare you set foot in our domain!
Oh, hey, you found your voice.
Where's the key?
I am a proud knight of Midgant. I'm not
about pretty proud earlier.
To the lights of petty demons.
There's nothing I hate more than someone else trying to control the direction of my life. My wheel is mine to hold. If
okay.
I'm not the one steering the ship, then I'm not truly alive.
The one steering.
Indeed. And my entire life is devoted to the defense of this fortress.
Then you better be ready to accept all that happens to you in the line of duty.
As you never know when you're gonna face a fucking cowboy.
Maybe it's time we found out just how deep your devotion truly goes. Take it easy. There's 9 more fingers to go.
Wait! The key is in the control room. It's through there.
One more question. Which way to the battleship?
You saw it was over there.
Straight ahead. Up the stairs.
Got it.
I don't get paid enough for this shit.
Well, thank you for handling that.
It just comes naturally. We need that key. But we also need to take out the battleship before it sails against the Von Eltia.
He's right. The control room or the docks? Which will it be?
You decide.
Let's start searching.
Okay.
That's not a decision.
You know, you're pretty good with your fists, Aizen.
Not as good as you are with your swords.
I feel like I've seen a lot of you with swords. Do you really never use them yourself?
No. Not with the Reaper's curse, I don't. It likes to rear its head at the worst times. I've broken blades just by unsheathing them. And once, just as I was about to deliver a finishing blow, my blade separated from the hilt and went flying. That sort of thing. A sword isn't something I can rely upon when my life is at stake. I fight using only my own body. That's one less thing that can go wrong.
But you won't believe how many fingernails I've broken.
I bet we could have had a hell of a fight.
I wouldn't need a sword to make it interesting. What do you say? Want to try your sword against my curse?
Sure, if the right time comes. Just don't whine when I end up winning.
You took the words right out of my mouth.
See, these guys are having a nice time. Why can't Velvet?
Well, here's where the real show starts. Do we have a plan, First Mate?
The fortress guards are almost all ordinary soldiers. Just a handful of exorcists to deal with.
They went to the trouble to build this huge gate. You'd think they'd keep it better defended.
You don't need an army of exorcists to keep a bunch of disorganized pirates under control, do you?
As long as they're fighting ordinary humans, the Royal Army would suffice.
So a few exorcists as officers is all they need.
It was built as a symbol of the Empire. But it seems Artorias is the one really giving the orders.
You don't say.
The army directs security and defense, and Imperial soldiers are under exorcist command.
We aim for the exorcists, then. The harder they are, the more fun it'll be.
Ready to bust some heads?
I'd rather cut them, actually.
Again, everyone is having a good time except for a certain someone. Maybe some two, I'm not sure. I can't go this way.
I say we check the control room for one.
Dude said the battleship was up the stairs. Let's take out the battleship first. Because I want to know if I can steal it. Loot everything! They have bats on patrol. I don't see the battleship this way. Isn't it a little early in the day for you guys to be out? I mean, if I recall, you're nocturnal. Plain paper. That's great. Oh, there's the battleship. Let's throw rocks at it. I can jump this gap. Whoa. I got demon skill. What was the point of that? Did the rock fall on something down here, or...? So many souls. So many bats! It's like a goddamn cave in Pokemon.
On to battle!
How scary is the Wraith? Okay, not very.
Your style is really unique.
Just wait until I pull out the good stuff.
I remember that wall guy being there. Whatever.
How do you plan to stop the battleship?
It's equipped with large cannons. The plan is to use their gunpowder against them.
Were we looking at the same battleship? Sake! You missed, bro. Okay, there you go. Hi.
An exorcist praetor?
The docks are up ahead. Like it or not, we're coming through.
Hey, wait. Are you intruders? I suppose it doesn't matter.
No, we're the help.
I will cut down any who consort with demons. Face the fury of the Rangetsu sword style.
Stand aside, Aizen.
No, you stay back. I'll take care of this one.
Sorry. This prey is mine.
Get in my way and I'll kill you too.
Have fun,
Reaper.
So, if you're going after the swordsman dude, why are you fighting the giant dog then? Well, you got it. I got him.
We're running out of time. You folks handle the ship.
Careful, Rokuro. He's...
I know. He's holding back.
Let's go.
He hasn't even taken off that stupid helmet.
Where did you learn the Rangetsu style?
I studied directly under the legate Shigure of the Abbey.
Lies. He'd never take on a student. Let me guess. He taught you a few things one time when he was super bored, and then crushed you with them.
Twin Blade Ignisite.
Is it done, Aizen?
We're set. It also serves as a good signal for the Von Eltia.
Now maybe we should unlock that gate.
Well, that was about the saddest practice I've ever had. But at least I learned where he is. Yo! The Abbey's my goal now, too. Now I can do what I have to do and repay my debt at the same time.
Is that your doing?
What? Is there a problem?
Not really a way to get ahead in life.
No.
A fine companion for the Reaper.
At least Rokuro really doesn't lose his head in battle.
We have to find that key. Let's get to the control room.
Between your sword style and that giant blade you shoulder, I wonder if you've got Rangetsu blood in you.
I do. What of it?
Have you heard the name Kushiyamada? I hear they're smiths with some connection to House Rangetsu.
Yeah, at least they're not called Hattori Hanzo.
Clan of kitchen knife makers. Why, are you interested in cooking?
No. I just heard they were fine blades. Thought one would make a good gift.
Don't.
Kushiyamata knives are cursed.
Hmm?
The blades themselves are excellent, but they give whoever holds one the urge to strike out at anyone and everyone. I've heard they use the blood of women they love in making their blades, but the truth is a mystery. The clan died out after they all turned on each other. The blades were all supposed to be melted down into slag. I suppose
that's well, that escalated rather quickly.
These days.
God.
Such is the fate of House Rangetsu. Or maybe it's just in our blood.
Sounds like there's even more to your clan than the rumors say.
Better than there being less, I suppose.
Turns out we were demons even before the blight. What are you gonna do? Still not entirely sure what the point of dropping that rock was. Wow, we fucked that ship up hard. Somehow we even made it not sit right in the water. Good job, team. Did I go here? I think I went here. Guy's still out cold. Wall. Rocks. Rocks fall, everyone dies. Plus souls. Nothing over there, nothing over there. And another life bottle. That's... Leave me alone, Zubat. Don't mind me. Wow, he really didn't mind me. Must collect all the shiny things.
You're fighting the Reaper.
Unleashed all my power. Maybe I overdid it.
Oh, there it is. Can't believe I missed a soul. As a fan of Dark Souls, I just can't let a soul go uncollected.
It won't open. It's locked from the inside.
That's a real thick door, too. This must be the control room, right?
That's my guess. We need another way in.
That window would probably work, if it wasn't all barred up.
It looks like a standalone building. Maybe we can find something on one of the other walls.
Maybe we can drop a rock on it. Maybe we already did. Nah, no we didn't. Oh god. Convenient. Earth ring. Well, good thing no one's in the control room to control things.
This seems to be the place. Let's split up and look for the key.
We'll search the other room.
Leave it alone, boy.
Aha. Found it.
Damn it, kid.
Don't get so worked up over a little thing like that. It's proof you're alive.
The bump is?
The pain is.
I'm talking about the pain.
But I'm scared of pain.
Well, kid, who isn't?
Even you?
I'm the exception.
Anyway, boys sure are fascinated by the weirdest things.
Fascinated?
Boys?
You like this, right?
I don't really know. But after I saw one in a book, I got a little curious about it. And I felt...
You felt excited, didn't you?
You felt aroused, didn't you?
I guess so. Do you know why the needle points north? Who figured out how to make it work? I thought that if I had one of these, maybe I could go on adventures. It's exciting.
When you feel that way, you should talk about it. About what you like and dislike. If you're happy or scared. After all, you're alive.
I'm... alive.
Tell me, for one, do you like or dislike that dress that you're wearing?
Not an order. Got that?
Understood.
You found it? Now we can get that gate open.
We needed a compass, too. Nice work.
Thank you.
Everything's ready. Let's get our gate on.
Can't believe he said that.
What's wrong? Are you not feeling well?
My compass fell on my head and gave me a bump.
Let me take a look. Ooh, wow, yeah, that's a big one. Bet that must hurt.
Yeah, but at least I'm still alive.
Always look on the bright side of life. Alive.
That's what Velvet told me.
Well, no worry. I'll just push your bump back down. You'll be good as new.
Wait, what?
I'm just messing with you. Don't sweat it.
Stop fooling around, you two. We have to hurry. Once we get back to the ship, just borrow some sugar and rub it on your bump. It'll make the swelling go down.
Oh,
home remedy.
Okay.
I promise I won't get mad if you talk.
Okay.
You're awfully fond of that, aren't you? Still, you should keep it in your bag for now.
If you break it, we're not getting you a new one.
You know, that's a nice bag. It looks made to last.
It's Moritz silk.
I've never heard of Moritz silk.
It's a fine fabric woven from the threads of the Dandarantula spider.
Ew.
It's got a delicate sheen, it's soft as a baby's skin, it's light and stretchable, it breathes, and it's quite durable.
And it came from a spider!
That's not all. Its most fantastic quality is how it absorbs impact.
My, but you're quite the scholar.
Knowledge and experience help you sniff out the best treasure. If you go and stuff every single scrap of plunder you find into your ship, she'll keel over.
You just want to be a fashion designer.
What I'm getting at is,
Your bag is the best place for you to keep that compass stored.
Unless you can shove it up your ass, but I don't think so.
Alright. Alright.
Anything else cool in here? Speaking of not looting everything. Have I looted everything? Think so. Looter, loser. It was the way to go. I get the odd feeling that maybe Velvet's a fan of Johnny Cash. I hurt myself today to see if I still feel, 'cause pain's the only thing that lets me know I'm real. Nah, surely not.
All right, it's open.
What was that?
It's the Von Eltia telling us they're approaching. Hurry!
All right. We'll pop the gate open for her. Quickly.
All right. Quickly.
Unfortunately, the gate takes about 2 hours to open even on the best of days, but, well, we'll make it go faster. Ah, lizards. Leaping lizards, Batman.
Wasn't worth the effort.
Gotta collect my plants. Gotta get my weed. And lavender. Hope I don't have to come back here anytime. Also, seriously, what did dropping that rock do? I'm still not sure. It made a loud noise. Did it do anything else important? What does this button do?
So, this opens the gate.
One side, yes. The gate has two giant doors side by side, with matching levers to open each.
Makes matching sense. Levers in different locations.
Alright, let's find the other device.
Did that need its own cutscene?
wish I had power like that.
I'd forget about it if I were you.
You see the curvature of the Earth. Take that, flatworlders. Oh, you? Fortunately, while one lever controls one side of the gate and the other lever controls the other side of the gate, they only work if you pull both levers.
And it's open.
Let's meet up with the Von Eltia. Back to the docks.
What's up, Doc? Oh boy. What do we have in here? I don't know if I want to know. 35. Sure, fine. God, you're horrifying. Get out of here. Didn't give me shit! Goddamn cat! There's no shortcut, is there? Oh well. Ah, cutscene shortcut. Also, put that back in your bag.
I can't let you do that. This is my This is my fortress!
How can a wall move that fast? Oh boy! Strain 3, break gauge levels will unleash an ultimate another mechanic. Use L2 during a combo. Okay. I guess you have to press square and not X to do the combo. This regards can be used to devastate foes by holding L2 during combo with 3 or more BG. These darts ignore the combo limit and are useful for extending combos when they reach the maximum. They also grant a soul. Now that we've got even more anime.
I call this an improvement.
The compass.
Anytime any of you other guys want to do the anime cutscene, you can go right ahead. I mean, I don't have the thing for it, but you guys do. I'm not sure what happened there, but I don't like it. I don't actually know how to change characters. Yo, one of you guys, heal me. Switch characters, L2, R2. Oh, okay. It's not working. Switch characters, L2, R2. Never mind. That's a little concerning, though.
The docks are swarming with demons. The Von Eltia will be overrun. Rats, we don't have long.
Aizen, can you signal for them to go through without stopping?
That'd keep them safe. But what about us?
We'll jump down onto it as it goes past. Is there another option? Aizen, give some kind of sign.
There's no need. The Von Eltia will sail through.
Without an order?
It was part of my plan. Welcome to the Eifried Way.
Wing it. Okay. Got it.
It's coming at full speed!
Let's get a move on then.
Hey, kid.
Will this really work?
Do you want the Reaper's reassurance?
Wait, what are you?
This is my store! Well, now that you've grabbed onto him, time to jump off the edge. Hey, wait a minute.
Let's go.
Heaven forbid he fall off the edge. Fill in this gauge, let the skaters unleash their hand, blah blah blah. BG blast gauge. Yeah, how do I fill this gauge? Oh, performing break souls. What the hell is the break soul again? Arts gain stars. The amount of a BG character receives at the beginning of a combat is directly proportional to the number of stars. All these mechanics can fuck off. Please.
Nicely done!
You're not going to thank your savior for her crafty cannonballing?
Oh, that's where the thing blew up.
I told you to stay away from the cannons, not bang on them.
But it was fun! And everything worked out, right? I'm sorry.
If it's that important to you, keep it safe.
By putting it in your bag.
Give it. I need to set a course.
Oh, come on, kid. You know it's safer with him than with you.
Fine. You read it for me then.
Did I say that out loud?
But listen, kid. Give me one false reading and you're shark bait.
Better work hard.
What's Luffy said?
It's a name. Your name.
My name? Luffy said.
It's a fine name.
Well, it's no
hope it serves you better than its last owner.
We're through the channel. Give us a course, Lafayette.
Aye, aye, sir. We're headed straight for Logris.
Is Logris really straight? Maybe you should look at that compass again. Looks like it's a little to the right there, dude.
Now this is refreshing. Sailing into port like normal people.
Well done, boy.
And dressed totally conspicuously.
Yes, I'm glad.
This won't be
at least I'm not dead.
Docking a pirate ship here?
So, how were the northern seas, Aizen?
Helaviz and Vortigern are in ruins. Trade with Northgand will likely be disrupted for quite some time.
Well, I like the sound of that. I'll have to act quickly.
Any word of the captain?
Aye. It's an old rumor.
Arr.
But they say Captain Ifrid was sent to Titania.
He's off to the Titanic.
I'm in prison overseen by the exorcists, huh? We'll have to look into that.
And here I thought the captain was a bird on that dude's hat.
As always, but even so, stay on guard. There's a grand ceremony being held in Logris. Lots of watchful eyes about.
Try not to look too anime.
I see.
Oh,
so
never mind.
Information for mooring.
Information for mooring?
Having the latest news gives merchants a chance to make favorable trades.
Having your rival ports be destroyed by pirates also makes for favorable trades.
Aizen and his crew have connections like this in nearly every port.
Not even the Abbey's iron decrees can withstand the force known as human greed. I see.
Don't bother going to Titania. You won't find Ifrid there.
And how do you know that?
Because I escaped from there. And before I did, I heard something from the prisoners. They said Ifrid was the only prisoner to ever get out alive, and that he was taken by an old exorcist named Melchior.
Lord Melchior is an elder legate at the Abbey. He should always be present at the headquarters.
Don't call him Lord.
Von Eifried's our
captain. And that's an order.
It's starting to look like his disappearance has connections with the highest levels of the Abbey.
Their headquarters should be in the capital, right?
Yes, at the Royal Villa in Logris. I've never been there, though.
And Velvet, your business is with a man in the capital, right?
Looks like we're all headed to the same place.
I won't apologize for involving you.
Usually I'm the one who says that. By the way, there's the little matter of your ship.
My ship?
My men brought her through the gate as well.
When did they do
We're
that?
We're going to use her as a scouting vessel.
Do what you want. We stole it in the first place.
A scouting vessel?
I've assigned Benwick to her. He'll give you the details.
I could have sworn I didn't see our ship behind your ship when you went through that gateway there. Do you think we should tell the merchant dudes about the fact that the Seagate is full of people turned into demons now? They might want to know about that. If you need anything, send a Sylphjay and the Vandal ship will salt to the rescue, wherever you may be. Yeah? What if we're inland? Not a problem! The crew will carry her if we have to. Good man. I do like the design of it. Though, I can't quite tell which way is forwards. Oh wait, there we go, yeah. Okay.
Aizen told us to come see you. What's all this about a scouting ship?
We're going to explore the outer seas. Oh, let me explain. Beyond the reaches of our kingdom lie vast, open oceans we call the Outer Seas.
And you're going to explore them? What for?
To make a map of the whole world, of course.
A map of the whole world?
That's right. Ifrit's pirates have many ambitions, one of which is the creation of a complete map describing the whole world. In fact, the Von Eltias already sailed all the way to the far continent for that very reason.
That's amazing.
You guys sure dream big.
I still don't get it.
Yeah, me neither. A map of a bunch of places nobody cares about? Big deal.
Well, regardless, if we're going to find anything in the vast waters, we'll need a lot of luck. We'd like to borrow some of yours.
And just how do you plan on doing that?
I want you to use your gut instincts to tell us where to look.
That sounds like a great plan.
The Von Eltia will be at your service. And you can keep anything we find in our explorations. You'll be able to assign us...
You guys are just really bored, aren't you?
By using a kind of messenger bird called a sylphjay.
Who knows? We might even come across some good treasure. Or maybe some rare food. Or brand new recipes.
That's a lot of treasure you can...
And by doing it this way, you, the player character, will never get to see these other worlds, so the game developers won't have to make them. Everybody wins.
Okay, as long as I'm not responsible for how things turn out, I guess I can help.
All right, then I'll tell you what you need to know.
Expedition. You can now send your scout ship on voyages. It's a whole level one. Can I name the ship? Go give me some lemons. These searching waters are constantly surged by a howling tempest. Most ships that enter are lost, but sailors who... what? Why is my... L1... Why are my buttons not working? Oh, whatever, it's probably because I'm still tutorialing. These four areas are determined by your current exploration level, which is displayed in the upper right of the screen. Select lemons to begin the voyage. So you're able to split the time remaining until your ship returns. Since this is your first time, the crew will break their back so that they can fly home.
Scout ship setting sail.
Amazing.
Take a look at this.
Let's see the results. What did you lose? During its exploration, the ship under crew will face 3 battles. The number of victories will determine the items and XP received. In their explorations, the crew might also uncover special rewards like recipes, new areas, and treasures. Some treasures may provide exploration skills. These skills provide much benefits. Neat. Ah. But sailors who survive the journey will find new strength in themselves. Now I can look at things. Go do it again. Send the ship will return at its normal speed. Take advantage of these expeditions to help you along in your adventure.
So now we just wait for news.
Who knows what we'll find? A sunken ship full of treasure, maybe?
Underwater ruins? Desert islands?
That we'll never see. Ruins,
perhaps.
Some fish would be enough for me. Especially if they sell well.
My thoughts exactly. Tuna or yellowtail or sturgeon.
Or mutton. Fresh mutton. Admittedly, though, doing this kind of makes me want to play Assassin's Creed Rogue again. I never did explore the entire map in that game. Maybe I should get Assassin's Creed 4. That's like $5 now, right? Oh god, what are you? As if cats by themselves weren't already terribly enough. This one's got balloons and a clown face. Slash, thrust, pop, and it thrusts at me. Who wants to play a game? Oh, the Van Valvali is docked here again. A bunch of odd merchants had it built. You didn't hear from me, but some say they're actually a bunch of pirates. Huh. As though wanted allies could just sail right into our ports. Interesting. So acting openly can sometimes draw less attention. That's quite the unexpected blind spot. Yeah, maybe we should act openly more often. Maybe not be so conspicuous with, you know, a certain, couple outfits some people might be inclined to wear. Just make you stand out a little. Food is being shipped around normally now. I can imagine such a thing 3 years ago. Really do owe the Exorcist a lot for allowing such a world to exist. The crew of the Van Vivali looks like a cruel bunch, but they're very polite and even swab the docks. I have the rougher sailors out there look to them as an example. You're right, but their skipper has a look inside that chills my very soul. Nearly 100 ships come through Port Zexon each day. It's like the beating heart of the Empire. That means that we're the ones running the world. After the Abbey, of course.
Have you heard? Marcus and his pirates were taken out by the Royal Navy.
So, he even got Marcus's crew now.
Of the 4 pirate kings who terrorized Midgand, only Ifrit and his crew remain.
What happened to Monkey D.
Aren't
Luffy?
Aren't the seas still swarming with pirates?
Only small fry that rob small civilian ships on the sly. But the only pirates left that can pick a fight with the Royal Navy and win are Ifrit and his crew.
In other words, the only ship left that's truly free is the Von Eltia.
For a merchant, you really seem to like these pirates.
He may be crooked, but money's not all he's after. If profit was his only desire, he could have made more by selling us
out. Don't say that right in front of him,
but
though.
That'd be too boring, don't you think? The fun's in making a killing by breaking the rules.
You're a funny guy.
I kill
and
you
that's
last.
That's why Ifrit goes through him whenever we need to dock here.
Well, I can't say I've ever met a human like him.
How many humans have you met, really? I mean, there were all the villagers in your village, but that was already depopulated, and then you went to prison for 3 years. Don't worry, I'll keep my promise. Honor among thieves and all, alright? Anyone who breaks that rule ends up with nowhere to turn. Wrong button. Oh, wrong. There we go. I still like how these look better. What's going on over here? Soon I'll be able to see the savior of the world with my own 2 eyes. Oh dear, have your tears welling up in them already? Hope this is worth the trip from the southern islands. I hear the ceremony is being held in the capital. Time to start moving, I guess. You don't seem to have any line on that rod. The docks are an arena for sailors. Walk too slow and they'll shove you in the water. At least that's what they all shout at me. Anyway, just be careful.
Crabs are amazing, right?
Oh yeah! They're delicious, boiled or grilled. Even their innards are yummy. And 5 sets of legs, that's so many!
That's all true. But what really makes them amazing is their miraculous ability to regenerate. They can detach their own legs when a predator attacks, which lets them get away.
It's called
if only I could do that.
And then, not long after they detach their leg, a new one grows from the stump.
Really? So you're saying we need to catch lots of crabs, then scare them so they detach their own legs?
Never-ending
exactly
food.
That's what I'm saying, bro. We can harvest as much as we like. No one's thought of this before. We're geniuses.
Huh. I never knew that. I thought only lizards could regrow a lost body part, and only their tails.
Lizards? Do you think Dial's tail can grow back?
If it does, we can make a killing by selling Dial tails.
Hey!
Maybe tasty?
Hey!
No idea.
Ugh. No way.
Hey, man. I hear it tastes like chicken. Brothers, let's get rich together and have all the crab we can eat. Into the crabbing business, he'll do in a pinch. Denora bottle. Denari? Hello, plot point.
The wind's kicking and the tide's flowing, and we're stuck here.
Then why not just set sail?
Not going to happen. The Abbey hasn't given us permission yet.
And we would need their permission, why? The Kingdom keeps a strict watch on harbors and sea routes. It's like they've erected walls and gates in the sea.
Aha! Midgand is spread across a number of islands. The sea is the only way to get from one place to another. If they can control the ships...
Until we unlock an airship!
People, goods, and even information.
Exactly. They even created that fortress, Vortigern, to help them do just that.
It's restrictive, but it's also necessary. Demons are out at sea too, and exorcists are the only ones who can stand against them.
Even still, it rubs me the wrong way. A sea dog obeys nothing but the winds and the waves.
So it's kind of impressive that they did manage to accomplish all this control in 3 years. Or was it 7? You a sailor or noble, everyone in the world has to obey their rules. Unless you're a pirate. It's not a lot of fun, but it's better than dying, right? Right. No ships have been coming in from Helaviz. Were they all attacked by Eifrid's pirates? Oh god. 75! Rosy cheeks. Fucking ripoff! Get back here with my souls, cat. Can you? Wow. You can't even see them. Lame as fuck, cat! Oh, whatever. Carrot. Why can't this be like Zillia 2 where I can actually collect cats? Literal cats. I'll watch over the storehouse for the Abbey. Be gone. No one is allowed inside without permission. Get thee hence. Get thee hither from mine eyes. Ugh, I thought I could finally have some fun making wagers, but all the forms of gambling have been banned. What a dreadfully stiff world we live in. Well, it's an Abbey rule, isn't it? Either obey or end up demon chow. Obey. Well, this seems interesting. But unfortunately, I'm going to have to stop here for now. To be continued, probably next time. But it is nice to see the characters starting to get along with each other. And, Nankuro and Aizen, especially starting to, like, enjoy each other's company. I hope more of the characters lighten up like that. I mean, I can understand why they wouldn't, considering all the shit that's gone down. Being tortured, being imprisoned, etc., etc., family members killed, etc., etc., but there's only so much, I don't know, bad temper, disposition that I really want to see in a character that I'm playing over the course of a however long game. But we'll see how it goes. And I think next time we see how it goes will probably be in like 23 hours from now, possibly. If I can pull it off. If I have the time. Alright, thank you all for watching. This will of course be on the YouTube channel. And if you want to get an email notification whenever I go live so you can watch it live, feel free to follow the channel here at Twitch. Or just bookmark our website at videovideo.net and keep that open in a tab or whatnot. We also have a YouTube or Twitch streaming group that you can join now if you want to stream for the VD2 community. Alright, thank you all. Later!